Do you want free SMS functionality in your project? Do you want to send free SMS from your project? Do you want to receive free SMS in your project? Do you want to use your own mobile device to send or receive SMS functionality in your project? Yes, you are at right place. Here we start. Hello guys, this is Mohammed Sadiq Odo. I have developed an Android application for the students who are newer in project development and then want free sending SMS functionality in their projects. This app is not just limited to particular programming language. You can send or receive as free SMS functionality in any programming language like Java, PHP, .NET or Python. What will we learn in this video tutorial? We will learn how to install GSM modem or SMS gateway and Android application in your device from Play Store. How to add credentials for SMS request. How to request for sending SMS. How to request for receiving SMS. We will check some JSON samples. We will add SMS limit within particular time. Let's run Play Store application in your device. Then search GSM modem SMS application. We will have green logo GSM modem application in front of you. Following application has to be installed before beginning to learn. When you run an application first time, you will see following main activity. Before you run an application, make sure your device is connected with local area network. In main activity, you can see following buttons and labels. Status. It is status of sending SMS server, which is stopped right now. Server address. It is the address of server where you will hit network call for sending SMS. Red circle button. It is a toggle button to start or stop server. Settings. This button leads you settings activity. We will cover this later. Users. This button leads you to user management activity where you will have to create the users with passwords to access SMS sending functionality on the network. JSON samples. This button leads you JSON sample activity where you can find some JSON URL samples. Before you hit a network call to send SMS, you need add a user with password. So click user button to jump user management activity. In user management activity, you can see plus floating button for adding new user in the application. There is also list of users with enable check. Click plus floating button now. Following pop-up will appear on the screen. In the pop-up form, both of fields username and password are required. It is up to you whether enable or disable user while adding new one. If you want to use this user for network call, you must enable it and save the button. You can also update existing user. Hold down on particular user, you will see pop-up form with user and password fields. In form, there are two buttons in bottom, update record or delete a record. Back to main activity. Now press red circle toggle button to start server. Let's hit network call from my Chrome browser in my computer. Before you hit a network call, you must check that your device and your computer are on same local network to communicate with each other. It is HTTP GET method request with following parameters: username, password, phone and message. When you hit a HTTP GET request in your browser with correct parameters, you will get JSON in return with phone number, message and status. Here message in return is message has been sent successfully. Now jumping to the setting activity. In settings activity, you will see following fields. Port number. This port number is used for sending SMS as you have seen on main activity with address. Get SMS URL add. There is a switch button. If you switch on, your server will get started. You will see the following notification while server is started or stopped. There is also input text field for receiving SMS URL. If your program is listening on particular address for receiving SMS event, let's check this listening program in Java for example. In Java, I have written a program for listening SMS event. When SMS received in device, it heads the address of my Java program which is running on my computer. You can see received SMS with phone number in logs. You want to develop complete program in Java from scratch, please check another complete video for sending SMS or receiving SMS functionality in Java. Let's get back setting activity. Number of SMS and number of minutes. It is a limit for sending SMS within a particular time. For example, no more than 55 SMS within 6 minutes. Jump to JSON sample activity. In JSON sample activity, you can see both URLs for receiving or sending SMS. For more video tutorials, please subscribe my YouTube channel